You showed skill making it to our central command, Wind Vestal. But unfortunately for you, you won't get any further if I can help it. I'll have you know I'm in top form today. Now you'll see just how helpless you are before me.
I bid you, Victoria, unleash your full power. Spare nothing.
I wouldn't have it any other way. I'll have my fun then close in for the kill.
Just as cold as before.
Thank you. Commend you for making it this far. The final painting lies beyond this throne. I shall reveal it to you if you defeat me in battle.
You're referring to the angel painting?
Precisely. You know much that has yet to happen, my friends. The last test is a test of strength. I shall only reveal the painting to those whom I deem worthy. One might also say that there is no need for those who are unworthy to lay their eyes upon it. But be forewarned, I am a formidable foe. I trust you are well prepared. I am a man of my word. Behold the final painting.
Silence, if you please. She would likely perish if we were to disturb her now.
It's happening again.
Again? What do you mean?
Oh, I was just thinking out loud.
Allow me to tell you a story, if I may. Once upon a time, in a place not of this land, there was an orphan child suffering an incurable disease. Her name was Victoria. Though still a child, she was abhorred by those around her due to her affliction, as the Orthodoxy cast her aside.
Huh? The Orthodoxy?
She was taken in and raised by the Orthodoxy soon after her birth.
This is new.
She simply waited upon her inevitable demise, all the while gasping in pain and despair. Then, a chance meeting changed her life. On death's door and abandoned, she was found by the Grand Marshal, who wandered the lands after renouncing the Orthodoxy himself. He took her to Yuliana, nursed her to health, then brought her to this realm for treatment.
My father did this?
How can you not know, as his daughter?
He never spoke a word of this.
Were it not for his lordship, her fragile life would have soon been snuffed out. I was pulled from my studies on the Earth Crystal to treat her. With the help of my father, who studied the amplification of white magic, she survived. But the treatment was not yet perfected, and she was left with terrible side effects. She suffers from periodic fits, which cause her body to writhe in pain. Her dread of these fits eventually caused her to lose all control over her emotions. But perhaps the most significant side effect was the cessation of her physical growth. Since my father and I began her treatment here, she has always had the childlike form you see.
If she is in such pain, how can you force her to use her powers?
I do not need you to tell me that. After the death of my father, I took over his research and have poured my heart into healing her body. But I could not relieve her agony, no matter how I tried. Each time her tiny form is racked with pain, I ask myself, knowing the result, would I still have intervened as I did? But ever is my answer the same. As long as I draw breath, I will see that she does too. No matter how she suffers, I'll not allow her to die. She is both my crime and my redemption, my ego, my joy. I dedicate my entirety to her, and know no greater pleasure.
What nonsense. I mean, really, Victor, that was so boring and really long, too.
Forgive me, Victoria. How do you fare now?
Back to my old self. but I don't think I could take another one of those fits. Now, let's take care of these fools once and for all.
Stop it! What is the point of us fighting?
The point, you ask? Because you disgust me, Idea.
What?
That is reason enough to fight? No. I wish to see your corpses splayed before me, fools!
Festal, I take it. Younger than I expected.
I am indeed Agnes Oblige, the Wind Festal. I did not expect to face you again like this.
Again, you say?
It does not matter. I do not intend to go against all the ideals you hold. But your hatred of the Crystal Orthodoxy and oppression of Crystalists, I cannot forgive. Why do you use force against them? Was discussion not an option? Do your ideals include spreading the flames of war, causing many innocent people to suffer?
You did what you did to save Mother, right?
Enough, Itzia!
You clearly do not understand my motives.
I don't?
I lost faith in the Orthodoxy 20 years ago. The same year that the Great Plague swept through all of Luxendark. The plague made its fury felt even here in Eternia. And many people died. But there was a way to stop it. By using the Earth Crystal to amplify the effects of white magic, the plague could have been eliminated. But my pleas to use this option fell on deaf ears, time after time. Instead, the Orthodoxy sealed off the roads, letting the plague decimate village after village. They claim to be our savior, yet leave people to die by the thousands just to save themselves.
So you took action, Father?
But the corruption of the Orthodoxy is trivial compared to the great secret of the crystals.
Secret?
When I left the Orthodoxy and met the sage in Ilyana, I was taught the secret of the crystals. If misused, the crystals could bring about the end of the world.
What? What are you talking about? The crystals are the light of humanity delivered through the prayers of the vessels through the ages.
You are not wrong. But that is merely one facet of the crystals, Wind Vestal. I could not entrust crystals with the power to end all existence to the Orthodoxy, whose only interest is self-preservation. Then, my worst fears came true. 15 years ago, the leaders of the Orthodoxy attempted the Grand Ritual for the sole purpose of enhancing their prestige.
The Grand Ritual? Surely not. The Orthodoxy would never use the power of the crystals in such a selfish manner.
A report suggested the Earth Crystal was extremely unstable by that point. If the Grand Ritual were conducted, Eternia could have faced destruction.
So you attacked the headquarters of the Orthodoxy and the Temple of Earth to stop this Grand Ritual, Father?
However, we were too late. By the time we got there, the Grand Ritual was already underway. Because of this, the Earth Crystal has been leaking power for the past 15 years.
So you prevented a crisis by tapping its power for the medical arts.
You finally understand. There may have been another way, I admit. But my feelings for my hometown and wife likely spurred me toward this solution. Wind Vestal, your awakening of the crystals may have edged us toward the harrowing.
You have it wrong! We awakened the crystals to save the world from the harrowing!
That is merely the Orthodoxy's view. I do not know what deceit lies behind it. I cannot allow those who act without proper understanding to tamper with the crystals. I won't waste my breath discussing it further.
Father!
sorry, Brave. This is all my fault.
Do not be absurd. This is hardly your doing.
Brave.
Wind Vestal. With these wounds, I shall never wield a blade again. I entrust the crystal to the Vestal. I have said my piece. Now it is for the Vestal to decide. I trust you will make the right decision. Do not summon the Pillar of Light. You must not.
Brave!
It's okay. He has lost consciousness, but swift treatment should save his life.
You look calm, Adia. It's as if you've grown up all at once. I do not blame you, you know. You must follow the path you believe is right, just as your father has done. Wind Vestal.
Yes.
You are not bound by the words of my husband. But do not discount them either. You are the last surviving Vestal. You are the hope that guides our people. Do not follow one belief blindly. Hear what others have to say before making your decision.
I will take your words to heart.
Thank you. You should go then.
Look after Father, Mother.
I will, of course.
Yeah.
have the hang of it, but if there's anything you'd like to go over again, just ask. Time to get started, Agnes. Are you ready?
Yes. Let us begin.
What is this light? The holy pillar?
It must be. Let us head there again, Agnes. This time, we must ensure we seal the great chasm and cleanse evil from the world.
Yes, I know. We cannot fail again.